G'day everyone, Tim from vMix here, and today we're looking at adding a Zoom call to your production. In this video, we'll be taking a look at two different methods of using Zoom on the same computer as you're using vMix. Firstly, the screen capture method will allow us to capture your full screen display from a second monitor. And this is going to work with pretty much most versions of Windows, and it's going to offer the best performance. Secondly, we'll go over the window capture method that will capture just the Zoom window, but this is only going to work on the very latest version of Windows 10 and in vMix 23. Now, ideally, you'd want to be running Zoom on a separate computer with about 15 production staff, but as that's probably not likely for a lot of us, including myself, we're going to show you how you can do it on your own. Now, if you want more information about how to use two PCs and connecting up Zoom, check out the description. Now, if you are looking to easily add remote guests, why not try vMix Call? It's just a couple of clicks to add a remote guest without any of these extra sort of hassles. All right, so to get this done, we're going to need to download some software from the internet. So you may need to pause and then download the programs or just wait until the end. There's going to be a list in the description with all of the different software that you're going to need to download. All right, so you're going to need Zoom, VB Cable Virtual Audio Device Software, the latest version of Nutek's NDI Tool Pack, which contains the NDI Virtual Input program. And I would also recommend having at least two displays connected to the same graphics card. Now, if you're using the window capture method, then you will need to have the latest version of vMix 23 or later, and the latest version of Windows 10. Now, have you got those things? I want you to write, yes, Tim, I've got those things in the comment, because it's not going to work unless you have those things. Now, because we're using third-party products, you'll need to make sure that you agree with their terms and conditions and their varying privacy policies. So as a very quick rundown of what's happening right now, we're going to be sending out our vMix output via NDI, making that available to Zoom using the NDI virtual input, routing the Zoom audio using the VB audio cable, and then capturing the Zoom display monitor into vMix or capturing the Zoom window. Now, if you want to follow along, there'll be a step-by-step guide linked in the description. All right, so let's get started. We're in vMix at the moment, and our first port of call is the settings menu, which is in the top right-hand corner. So we're going to go up to the top right-hand corner, go to settings, and then we're going to go to output slash NDI slash SRT, which is the second one here. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to make our vMix output available on the local network via NDI. So along the top here on the output number one, I'm going to turn on NDI by clicking this button here. So that's now going to be available on the network. So next of all, I'm going to click the little gear icon next to it. And then for the audio channel, I'm going to select bus A. So this will enable the NDI output from vMix with the bus A audio included. So using bus A audio means that we can control what audio is being sent back to Zoom to avoid any sort of audio feedback. Now, if you are using bus A for something else, you could use a separate bus here for routing the audio. That's up to you. Okay, so we're just going to click OK down the bottom here. And then what we're going to do now is go to the audio outputs section. Then what we want to do is make sure that we have bus A enabled, because that's what we've selected in the NDI output settings. However, if you set up a different bus in there, you'll just need to make sure that's enabled from this list here. Now, what you can do if you haven't got it enabled, you just select it and then click enabled here, and then vMix will restart to change those audio output settings. All right, so we're going to click OK now. So now we're just going to go down to the audio mixer in vMix, which is in the bottom right-hand corner down here. So what we want to do now is activate the bus A button on any audio inputs that we wish to send to Zoom. So for example, a microphone input. So as you can see here, I've got my camera, which has embedded audio on the microphone, and I want to make sure that I've got A selected here. So I want to make sure that that's green, and I'm sending my microphone out via the A bus and NDI into Zoom. Now, if you had set up a different bus here, you could either select A, B here, or right click on it and select any other buses that you have available or enabled in vMix. Now, another thing that you might want to do is choose to turn down the volume of your microphone in your headphones, so you're not going to hear your own voice talking to yourself. So in order to do that, you'll just need to click on the little cog icon for the input, and then you can click this here to turn off your headphones, or you could adjust the audio here if you wanted to. So now we've got our audio output sorted, we're going to now take a look at the NewTek NDI Virtual Input. So what we're going to do is go into the settings here and search for Virtual Input. There it is there. We're going to click on it. Now it's going to appear in your task tray down the bottom. So once running, you'll be able to see it down here. You'll be able to click this and open it up. Now, if you right click on it, you'll be able to see any sort of source that you want to attach to the virtual input. So I've got Beacon here, which is the name of my computer. And then what I'm going to do is make sure that I've got vMix output one selected. So that's my output here that I want to send to my Zoom call. So I'm going to make sure that that is selected. So now that we've made our vMix output available to be used in Zoom, we're going to jump over to Zoom here. As you can see, I've got Zoom set up on my laptop that I'm calling into my main studio PC here. So now we need to go about setting that up. So you'll notice that I have it on a full screen here. I have it running on a full monitor, which is going to make it easier to capture. And it's also going to be easier to use if we use the window method. So firstly, we're going to configure the Zoom audio. So what we're going to do is select the little arrow next to the microphone down here. And then what we're going to do firstly is for the microphone, we're going to select line, NewTek NDI audio. And then for the underneath the speakers section here, we're going to select cable input. So the VB audio virtual cable here, we're going to select that under the speaker. The microphone option will send audio from vMix to Zoom. And the speakers option will allow us to send the audio coming out of Zoom into vMix. So next we're going to configure the Zoom video source. So with a little arrow next to the video here, I just need to select that. And then I need to choose the NewTek NDI video option right up the top. I'm going to select this here. So as you can see on my laptop here, I now have my vMix output coming into my Zoom call. So that's now being received via this laptop, and this laptop is sending this video to this screen here. Okay, so now that our guests have joined our Zoom meeting, we can go ahead and add them into vMix. So in order to add the video, what we're going to do is go and select the Add Input button from the bottom left-hand corner down here. Then what we're going to do is select the NDI / Desktop Capture option. Then we're going to go to Local Desktop Capture, and we're going to select the display that we're currently running Zoom on. So as you can see here, I'm running it on my second display. That's what it's called in Windows. So I'm going to select Display 2 here and then click OK. So as you can see now, I've got my display here. That's my Zoom call coming through from my laptop. And then that's now available in my vMix production to be used. So now we have our Zoom video in the production. We just need to go ahead and add the audio. So we just go to Add Input, and then go to the audio input section. And then we just need to select the cable output here. Then click OK down the bottom. Now you should be able to hear the audio from that video that's now playing in Zoom on this laptop here. So you should be able to start hearing that in the production. So I'm just going to turn that audio off now. So one thing that you do want to consider when you've got all of your audio routing, make sure that you don't then turn on bus A for the Zoom audio that's coming in, or it's going to loop around. So make sure that you don't select bus A to send that back to them because they don't want to hear themselves. So now that we have that as a part of our production, I can start bringing in that Zoom call. I can create a picture in picture, a double box, all that kind of stuff. So now I'm going to show you how to do the window capture method. Now the audio is going to be exactly the same. It's just a different way of capturing the video from Zoom. So what we need to do is go to Add Input. Then what we need to do is then go to the NDI Desktop Capture, and then Local Desktop Capture, and then we need to select which Zoom window it is. Now it may be any number of these, so I'm going to select the third one here, it's usually what it is. Now from the Windows Capture method, you'll need to select Windows Graphics Capture. So I'm going to select this one here, and then click OK. So now that I've added the Zoom window, I can start using it as a part of my production. Now I've got mine set up on a second monitor still, and that's because that the direct Windows capture at the moment doesn't allow you to get rid of the cursor. So when you've got it on a second monitor, that doesn't matter. So you need to make sure that it's maximized at all times. Do not minimize the window or it's going to disappear. So make sure that it's maximized at all times. Now you can still bring things above it, like as you can see here, vMix, it's still going, but I've got something above it. So it's a little bit different to how you would have the display capture. As you can see here, my cursor is going over it, but that's on a second monitor. So that's one of the issues with potentially using it on a single monitor, is that you will see the cursor. Now in the future, Microsoft plans to be able to remove this feature, but we don't know an ETA on that currently. Now, as a best practice, we usually do recommend that people use two monitors for their live streaming and live production. That way they can monitor their multi-view or their program output. Now, you might see other methods for using Zoom with vMix. However, the methods that I've shown you today are the ones that we're supporting. There are some other video rendering options in your Zoom settings, but these can cause high CPU and they're not great to be using while you're doing a live stream and a live production on the same computer. Now, if you want to have a go at these, by all means, try it out. But when your live stream breaks and doesn't work, please don't send us an email. So I'm sure we'll get some comments and suggestions about different ways to do it. So you might just get a shrug emoji from me. Sorry about that. Okay, so if you have any issues with Zoom, feel free to send them an email. If you have any vMix specific questions, drop us an email via the contact page on vMix.com. If you want some hassle-free video calling, why not try vMix Call? And finally, all the information in this video will be linked in the description. So any links or software downloads or anything like that will be in the description. So thanks for watching, and we'll stream you later.
Thanks for watching. Click to watch another exciting vMix video or head to vMix.com for a free 60-day trial. See you later.